meteorologist Michael Coates.
We're going to finally return to a more December-like pattern here. Temperatures are going to be below freezing at best throughout much of the day here to take us into Christmas. Cold air is moving on the backside of the weekend storm that is now getting into the north and South Dakota and out through Nebraska there with some snow and rain. What we have here locally, patchy freezing fog tonight. It's going to be cold enough, and there's still some leftover moisture in the atmosphere. We're going to be awfully close to that dew point. We're going to start developing some of that valley fog. In that fog, you may see some light snow or even some slick road conditions. So that's when we say freezing fog. That'd be very icy on some of the roadway surfaces. So we could see a little bit of black ice early tomorrow morning within that fog. You have to take precautions there. High pressure with us here for a couple of days, and then we're waiting for the Christmas storm to get in here. And it looks like things are still on track to at least pull in some moisture as we head into your Thursday and a bit of your weekend. So let me take you to ViperCast. 9 o'clock tonight, some lingering snow flurries, light snow showers, western Wyoming, Lincoln County, Teton County, up through around the Continental Divide there through Montana and up around the border with Island Park. As we get in through tomorrow, a few passing clouds. I don't see much of anything coming through here for Tuesday. Lighter winds, temperatures are going to be colder, that's for certain, and we could see that patchy fog. Once again, also going into Tuesday night and Wednesday morning, I wouldn't be surprised if we saw another round of that fog. Here comes the storm. This is going to start to happen around dinner time Wednesday night. We start to thicken up the atmosphere with that cloud cover. We start to saturate the atmosphere. And we're going to start seeing snow slowly taking hold as we start to eat our Christmas Eve dinner. And then getting into Christmas morning, we're going to start to see more of these snow showers really start to ramp up. It's going to happen mostly as we go to bed Wednesday night into Thursday morning that things could get a bit messy. And you can see some pretty heavy snow getting into western Wyoming. Still for Christmas morning, we're looking for some scattered snow across the Snake River Plain, southeastern highlands especially, some spotty snow showers across central Idaho, and then it begins to clear out. Then we're going to carry in a few spotty snow showers as we carry in to the holiday weekend. Now, I want to take you to the latest model. You got to take this with a grain of salt. We're a few days out, so things can happen. Okay, so the latest computer models that I'm leaning towards here, 1 to 3 inches for the Snake River Plain, and this is through Christmas night. So Thursday night at 10 o'clock, that's where the model stops. Could be looking at about 5 inches in Jackson, 6 inches in Island Park, 5 inches in Stanley, and you can see here about 1 to 3 inches in the Snake River Plain. Could get pretty snowy in the mountains around Malad. In town Malad, maybe a little bit lower than that 6.4 reading, but we definitely have some snow that's going to try to work in here. And it's cold enough that all across the area that we could actually have that snow sticking around for quite some time. So patchy fog tonight, lighter winds tomorrow, and then 1 to 3 inches of new snow Christmas. And that may change. Again, we're a couple days out from that storm. But I just wanted to give you a heads up that it's a possibility in the future. Cold tonight, 8 in Jackson, 9 for Driggs, 19 for Idaho Falls, 21 for Pocatello tonight, and 20 for Aberdeen. We're clearing out, but we still have that fog tonight. We're at 19 for Soda Springs and 13 for Montpelier with 12 in Afton. Temperatures tomorrow, we're coming back. We're going to see the numbers only getting into the 20s and 30s. So we had the 40s over the weekend, but now that colder air is seeping through on the backside of the cold front, and it's doing its damage. 33 for Pocatello, 38 in Burley, written 29 for Idaho Falls, upper 20s for Rexburg, mid-20s for Driggs, mid-20s in Dubois, the upper 20s at the site, upper 20s to lower 30s around Chalice and Salmon. Let's get to the 8-day forecast. Idaho Falls got you dropping into around 30 degrees by Christmas Day. It's going to be quite windy Christmas Day as well with the storm passing through. The weekend, highs around 30 and spotty snow showers to carry us in to the early part of next week. Pocatello also looking at dropping temperatures. A high of 32 for Christmas Day and 29 on Friday. So Pocatello, if we do get snow, we may finally get it to stick around for at least a day or so as we carry into the Christmas weekend. Rexburg, 31 for Wednesday, 30 for Thursday. And it's going to be cold enough definitely in Rexburg. If we do get snow, it's going to stick around all weekend long. Blackfoot, we'll see passing snow showers again Wednesday night through Thursday, windy on Thursday with winds around 10 to 20 miles an hour. We'll see teens and 20s overnight. Salmon, a mix of rain and snow early Wednesday, but that's going to turn to all snow as we go Thursday morning. Thursday, it's going to be windy in Salmon with a high of 33, mid-20s the following weekend there for Saturday and Sunday. Jackson, lots of snow here for the mountains, which is where we like to see it. And if you got the snow machine, if you get the snowboard, you're going to be happy with Santa's gift there. Temperatures into the 20s. Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Overnight lows in Jackson. Pretty cold. Getting back into the single digits.
So the timing is just perfect on for this white Christmas thing. How did you manage that?
How did I manage that? I just have these powers.
No. That's it.
Now, here's the thing, though. It could change a little bit. I mean, the storm is still a few days out. Everybody's talking about Christmas, so I want to make sure I got the latest forecast in here. So stay tuned for the next couple of nights because it may shift slightly. But all the models are lining up and showing that, yeah, we get a nice. It's not going to be an all-out blizzard or a massive snowstorm, but we can get some passing snow showers here, maybe a little bit of the white stuff.
That will be nice.
For Christmas.
Okay, thank you, Michael. Well, the week is only going to get busier the closer we get to Christmas, but here's one thing not to neglect, your tree. Tonight, we take a closer look at the dangers of letting your tree dry out and how to avoid letting something like that happen. And when is the last time you just looked at the stars? If you live in a big city...